Hello student, this is your online session for class 6 for chapter 5, that is getting started with Microsoft Excel. Okay, so in this we discuss about the topic Excel, that is also known as the spreadsheet. Okay, so Excel is a computer program used to create electronic spreadsheets. Okay, within Excel user can organize data, create charts and perform calculations. Excel is a very convenient program because it allows the user to create large spreadsheet reference information from one spreadsheet, and it allows for better storage and for modification of information. So students, Excel is a computer program used to create electronic spreadsheets. Within Excel, user can organize data, create charts and perform calculations. Excel is a convenient program because it allows the user to create large spreadsheet reference information from other spreadsheet, and it allows for better storage and for better modification of information. So Excel operates like other Microsoft Office program and has many of the same functions and shortcuts of other MS program. Like other MS program, Microsoft Excel has same functions. Okay, so now let us discuss about the overview of Excel screen. Okay, Microsoft Excel consists of workbook. Within each workbook, there is an infinite number of worksheets. Okay, so first we discuss Microsoft Excel consists of workbook. Okay, basically workbook is a collection of worksheets. Within each workbook, there is an infinite number of worksheets. Okay, now each worksheet contains columns and rows. In worksheet, there are rows and columns. Where a column and a row intersect is called the cell. When one column and one row intersect and form a rectangular area, that is called a cell. For example, let us take one example. For example, cell B6 is located where column B and row 6 meet. So here is example of B6. So where column B and row 6 intersect, then they form the B6 cell. Okay, the tabs at the bottom of the screen represent different worksheets. Within a workbook, you can use the scrolling button on the left to bring other worksheet into view. Now, on the tab, there is a view which shows you how many worksheets are available. Okay, so the name box. Now, the another term is about the name box. The name box indicates what cell you are in. So, a name box indicates the active cell. Basically, in which cell you are in or the active cell. This cell is also called the active cell. This cell is highlighted by a black box. Okay, whenever when your mouse pointer is there, then that cell is highlighted by a black box. That is called active cell. Okay, the is equals to is used to edit your formula on your selected cell. The is equals to sign. It means is equals to sign is used to edit your formula on your selected cell. Okay, now the next one is the formula bar. The formula bar indicates the content of the cell selected. Okay, whenever you press on cell formula bar, the content of the selected cell will shown on the formula bar. Okay, so format menu. Now next one is format menu. You can change the colors, border, size, alignments and font of a certain cell by going to the cell option on the format menu. So in format menu, you can format the cell by using different colors, border, size, alignment and font of a certain cell. So by using all these, you can easily format your cell. Now, the next one is view menu. You can change the view of your work so that it is page by page. You can easily set the view. So in this, you can easily set the view by using page by page option. You can insert header and footer to your work. You can easily insert header section and footer section on your worksheet. You can add comment about a specific cell for future reference. If you want to add something more or something that you can not remember, or you want to use for further for future use, so you can easily create a comment section about that particular cell. Okay, entering formula. Next term is your entering formula. When entering numerical data, you can command Excel to do any mathematical function. Okay, whenever you want to write numerical data or you want to do mathematical calculation, you can easily do it. Okay, start each formula with an equal sign. So there is a rule here. Whenever you want to do calculation or you want to apply some mathematical operation, then you have to start your formula by is equals to sign. Okay, so for example, addition formula. Let us take example of addition formula. To cell together, if you want to add two cell together, then you then which sign is used? That is plus sign. Okay, to sum up, so this is to sum up a two cell data, you can use plus sign. For example, is you have what you have to write, that is equals to me is equals to sum. Okay, sum your cell reference number, your cell address, okay, up to colon, up to that particular cell address. Okay, then you by pressing enter, your cell will be added. Okay, your cell data will be added. Okay, now there are some tips for entering your data. So to highlight a series of cell, first, to highlight a series of cell, click and drag mouse over the desired area. Okay, so for highlighting your cell, first tip is to click and drag the mouse over that desired area. To move a highlighted area, click on the border of the box and drag the box to the desired location. If you want to drag one cell data to another cell location, you can easily do it by drag and drop option of mouse. Okay, so you can easily sort your data alphabetically, numerically, etc. Okay, so you can easily sort your data according to your choice by using alphabetically order or by using numerical order. Okay, so this is all about your Excel startup. So in this we studied about, in this we discuss about what is Excel. Okay, it is actually a spreadsheet software. Okay, we also discuss about the screen of Excel, and we also discuss about the many menus like format, okay, like view and the formula. So so this is all about your today discussion. So be safe, stay at home and be healthy. Okay.